Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. To master her love, you have to practice love. The art of relationship is a whole mastery, and the only way to reach mastery is with practice. To master a relationship is therefore about action, not about attaining knowledge. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 197, NASDAQ's up 113, S&P's are up 19.5, gold contract up $17.30, trading 1783 an ounce. Silver up 18 cents, $18.08 an ounce. Light sweet crude down 41 cents, $40.32 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You have the 10-year right now up 138.23. The 30-year down 11 at 176.30. And King Dollar. King Dollar's down 363 ticks, trading 96.676. The euro is at 113. The yen is at 106.5. And the British pound is at 125 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world and the world of the S&Ps. Let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, let's go over to the, we'll go over to the futures first. Take a look at the futures. Futures have been quite a ride when you take a look at the last 24 hours, folks. Bottom line, as we opened this morning, you wouldn't have known that the futures traded down to 30.60 last night. That being said, where we are right now, you're up 21 bucks. Bottom line, we just came down into the price point of 31.28. You're 31.31. Now, in order for the futures to basically really get going into the downside, 31.25 would be the number. We'd have to get back under 31.25. It gets under that, you know, the next 20, 30 minutes. Then you actually could have a market that basically is flat or in the red a bit. Now, what's very unusual, there's no two ways about this, is that when you get an S&P up 21 bucks, and then we go over to the NASDAQ, I mean, forget it. The NDX 100, folks, bottom line, you hit 10,296 out here today. You're not only broke the highs here, you got away from the highs. The highs, we hit 10,296. Right now, you're 10,243. Yeah, granted, no two ways about it. We go over, we know what's driving the market. You get Apple, new all-time highs. It's up $10.50. We go to Microsoft. You take a look at Microsoft. Microsoft is up $2.25. Netflix, NFLX. These are the movers in an extraordinary way. Netflix, same deal. Amazon, I believe Amazon broke its highs out here today, too. Amazon, same deal. And Amazon also, you know, Amazon had that high volume high at 27.22 and you're 50 bucks above it. So, yes, there are a few stocks that are running the market. Yes, there is no two ways about that. The divergence that I'm talking about that is pretty intense is the aspect that you get the NDX 100 saying, guess what? The moonshot is here. We're going to go to freaking Mars. We're going to go wherever we're going to go. And the S&P can't get any traction. Gold. Gold contract out here. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract is pushing into its highs with volume. It looks like the gold contract wants to break out. The gold contract has multiple ABC structures. It has a small ABC structure that it took out the B point yesterday. You have a price projection there of 1801. Your swing high right now is 1789. It has a larger ABC structure that took out the B point on April 7th, and that structure is 1821 to 1825. Bottom line, folks, when you have multiple ABC structures, it brings the probability up once again that guess what? This thing is going to break topside. You definitely, if you have the art of time in the trade, my book, you know that when you start pushing into swing points, whether they're higher swing points or going to lows, and you see the expansion of volume, your probability goes up dramatically. They're just going to blow right by that baby. And I expect that's exactly what we're going to do. It's a Wyckoff term. Wyckoff's a technical trader that had a couple great books in the 20s, 1920s, that is. Bottom line, this is a jump in the creek. That's what this is looking like. So you come up to the top of the consolidation, resistance, whatever you want to call it. Bottom line, you jump the creek. It doesn't even give it a chance to basically trade at that price. It jumps right over it. That, well, actually, let's go look at the silver contract as we're doing this. So silver right now, that's getting volume behind the move also, 71,000 contracts. That's good contract volume inside the silver market. We are up 19 cents right now. And you can see yesterday you did 75,000. Today we're already at 71, and you're going into 62. This is a good setup. Silver needs more price. That's what's happening right here. You know, you have the volume. Now you want to see that thing get stretched on price. King Dollar. What do you have with King Dollar? So King Dollar, this is going to be really pretty cool watching out King Dollar trades tomorrow, and this is why. When King Dollar first came down, folks, okay, so first off, we have a low established March 9th. The low is 95,650. The high of that low is 94,650. The high is 95,780. We came down, straight down. We went down to 95,716. That was on the 10th of June. We rejected lower price. It goes higher. We turn yesterday and start coming back down. Now, the reason that tomorrow is going to be really important is this. The real question is going to be, what we did out here today is that we hit 96,385. Well, 96,456 is the high of the low that was established on June 10th, which rejected the high of the low on March 9th. So if we do get a bounce out of here tomorrow, then the dollar basically saved itself once again. So it's going to be really intriguing. So if it saves itself, that means it's going to go run back to the 97,739. That's on a very short-term basis. On a bigger basis, the dollar only did a 0.382 retracement, which is a dead cat bounce. Bottom line, we'll see where this shakes out. The dollar, the reason that you've seen so much selling in the dollar, if we go over to the euro, you're going to see the euro caught a monster bid out here today. The euro yesterday was trading at 111.69. We got up to 113.49 inside the euro. The euro broke the downtrend that had been in place since June 10th. Bottom line, looks to me that the euro is going to continue going higher. Dollar lower, gold higher, silver higher. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow Industrials up 217, NASDAQ up 118, S&P's up 21. We'll come right back.